Well, as with most things right now, decluttering looks different. And so today I want to share a few tips of how you can still be really successful simplifying your house, even if you don't feel like you have a ton of mental capacity. That's totally okay. We just need to shift our mindset a little bit and you can still get a ton done while you're at home. Dawn from The Minimal Mom. We love sharing tips and tricks about how you can simplify your house quickly. And so today I want to talk about a few tips of how we can still be successful decluttering and simplifying our homes, even if we find ourselves feeling like we don't have a lot of capacity for critical thought, we don't have a lot of extra energy, and we just don't feel like it, right? Because most of us can relate to that right now. So tip number one is to recognize how much stress our clutter is causing us. If you look at the brain science behind it, if we are in a cluttered space, it causes low-level anxiety or that fight or flight response. Now, this is heightened right now because most of us are already feeling that sensation from what's going on in the news and in the world around us. And so pair that with a cluttered environment and it's really putting a lot of us on edge and it's causing us not to be able to relax or feel at peace or feel safe in our own homes. And so this affects us as adults, but it also affects our kids and the other people in our household as well. And so it has never been more important for us to figure out a way to stay on top of keeping our house tidy. It doesn't have to be perfectly cleaned or deep cleaned, but it is really important right now for us to recognize the impact that our space is having on it and to use that as motivation to keep our house a little bit neater right now while we're safe at home. So tip number two is the power of the 2-minute tidy. And so we've talked about the 2-minute tidy before, especially when we are lacking energy. And so again, because we're in that fight or flight response, we're all feeling a little overloaded, overwhelmed, it causes us to feel kind of blah and lack the motivation to do these tasks like tidying up. And so that's where the 2-minute tidy is so powerful because you're only committing 2 minutes of time. But here's the other reason why it's especially effective is that when we're feeling anxious, usually the right side of our brain is overstimulated. And so a way to self-regulate is actually to do something active or physical, and that helps reconnect the left side of our brain and to bring down the activity in the right side of our brain. And so that's why a lot of times you'll hear tips like to go for a walk, even doing something like knitting or crocheting, it helps to bring that alignment back. But the 2-minute tidy can be equally as effective. And remember, tidying isn't cleaning or deep cleaning. Tidying is simply grouping like items with like items. And so like here in our kitchen, which Maggie and I are gonna tidy right now, it's putting all the dirty dishes together. It's putting all the garbage in the garbage can, putting the food back in the cupboards with the other food. It's simply putting like items with like items. But you know as well as I do, the power that it has to not only get our space to feel more peaceful again, but also to motivate us to take the next step, which that is decluttering. And so again, a lot of us right now, I think we feel like we have diminished capability for critical thought, right? Like, I don't actually wanna make any big decisions right now. And that can apply to decluttering as well because we second guess ourselves and say, well, am I really of sound mind right now to be making these decisions if I should be getting rid of this stuff? But by starting with tidying first, it helps us to understand, okay, what things in my kitchen are homeless? What cupboards are too full right now? Or, you know, it's pretty safe to say that the stuff that's out on the counters is getting used, but when I go to put that stuff back away, what's tucked in the back of the cabinet? What's been sitting back there not getting used? Seriously, if you're not using it now, what would possibly change in the next month or 3 months that would cause you to use it? These I do use, but really take a look at the item and remember, what's more important right now is peace of mind of having our cupboards only be like half full. I love that because you can move stuff around easily and see what's in there. And so now more than ever, I think it's important to value our peace of mind, our emotional well-being over stuff that can be replaced. We just need our house to feel good right now. So by tidying first, it helps us to self-regulate, gives us a little more energy towards taking that next step to decluttering, but it also helps us to realize what things in our kitchen are we simply not using. And remember, we all make mistakes. So I bought this for like a serving bowl. It's just from the dollar store. I mean, I'm debating over a dollar item right now of like, well, should I keep this? Because maybe another time I've never used this when we posted like the last few times. So this is the type of stuff that I need to stop keeping for someday and realize that I'm not gonna use it. And worst case, I could replace it for a dollar. So what are we talking about here? And that leads us to number four, is to realize the if not now, when principle. If I'm not using these things in my kitchen now, when we are doing, I don't know about you, but this is the most cooking we have been doing at home, like ever, right? And so if I'm not using the gadgets and the appliances and the recipe books now and in the next month while we have extra time, when am I possibly gonna use them? And I know a lot of us get hung up on gadgets and appliances and things that we've spent a fair amount of money on, especially in the kitchen. And most often these items were created to make our life easier. They have a very specific purpose. They usually try to sell you that they can do all these different things, but usually we bought it for like one purpose. Like this, I wanted to make bulletproof coffee, right? And so, but I didn't like it. It never sat well in my stomach. So I don't know, I was probably doing something wrong with it. But I don't use it anymore. And I thought, well, maybe I'll make tomato soup with it. I don't make my own tomato soup, right? So I've been hanging on to this for someday when I might decide I like bulletproof coffee again, or I might decide to make tomato soup. But again, I don't actually anticipate that being in my future, and I could always use my Vitamix too. Like, I don't have to have an immersion blender. So now's the time to be really realistic about what we're actually using and what we're not. But the cool thing is, you're gonna love having the extra cabinet space, having less stuff to manage and to take care of, and less stuff to make a mess in your house. So it's really win-win-win, and keeping this does not put any money back in my pocket. And so this can really help us to take a really realistic look at the things in our kitchen and say, if I'm not planning to use it in these next few weeks, it is very safe to say that I'm not gonna use it moving forward. I love this beautiful artwork that we have on our fridge right now, but it does contribute to visual clutter, and so it's beautiful, I love it. We're gonna keep a couple of them in our keepsake bin, but then the rest are gonna go now. Did you make? I know you made some of them too, right, Megs?
I made all of them.
They're awesome. We're gonna keep these ones.
I'm too
short. So we're gonna keep the top two, and then the other ones we're gonna let go for now, so you can create more artwork, right? All right. All right, tip number five is don't try and do it alone. We are isolated enough right now, and so recruit anyone else in your house that you can to help you. Did you have fun helping pick up the kitchen? Yes, we even took it a step further and loaded the dishwasher and cleaned up the counters too. So it feels really good. And truly, by having our kitchen simplified already, even though it really did look like a complete disaster, it just took us like 10 minutes to get it all pulled back together, dishwasher loaded and all the counters wiped down. So keep working to reduce the inventory in your living spaces, and they're gonna be so much easier to keep clean. And I don't want to sound like a broken record, but I think this might also be a really good time to try having your counters completely cleared off. I think most of us just need that peace of mind right now and the peace that comes from it. And so we just keep our coffee pot out, and then we have the little dish with like our scrubby thing to wash dishes. And that's it. But here's what's cool about it and why it works so well is that then mentally, I know that if there's something out on the counter, it doesn't belong there. Like, my brain doesn't ever have to sort or inventory. It's like, something's on the counter, it needs to go away. And so this can be another way to help us declutter our kitchen cabinets, is by making space for this. And so there's probably stuff tucked in the back of your cabinets you're not using that you could get rid of to make space for this stuff that's been sitting out on the counters. And I think just try it. Like, if you just try it for like a week and see if you like it and your family likes it. And if you don't, you can just pull everything back out. But I think you'll find that it just feels really good to have them cleaned off. And of course, the name of the game right now is bite-sized pieces. You will be so amazed if you just do a little bit every day, how it really adds up to a house that's easy to maintain, to keep picked up, and enjoyable to be in. And that's the whole point of this. And so if I were you, here's what I would do. I would remember that right now it's more important than ever to keep our spaces tidy and picked up, and that we need a little bit of activity every single day, whether it's exercise or tidying, to help our bodies self-regulate. But the good news is the tidying will help you know what you should be decluttering right now. What are you actually using, and what's just a pipe dream or something you're keeping for your fantasy self or future self. And don't try and do it alone. Even if you text a friend or a family member, say, hey, my house has been driving me bonkers. I really wanna try and keep it picked up every night before we go to bed. So here's a picture of my clean kitchen tonight. Will you help hold me accountable? Celebrate wins with other people. Involve your family members. Involve your kids. They need to feel needed right now. And of course, it's great life skills too. And if you're really feeling uncertain about what you're getting rid of right now, don't be afraid to pull out a quarantine bin or a triage bin. Put the things in a box, mark the date, and don't worry about deciding right this minute if you're gonna donate them or not. Plus, a lot of places you can't donate right now anyway, so throw them off to the side and you can make that decision another day. So I hope this helps. I'd love to know, what are you doing right now to stay motivated, whether it's simplifying and decluttering or just keeping your house picked up at the end of the day? Let us know, that's always so helpful to read, or what areas are you struggling with? We'd love to cheer you on. A thumbs up is the best compliment that you can give us. I hope you subscribe so that we can keep working through our houses together, and I'll look forward to visiting with you again soon.